Hello, I found a quote that I absolutely love. It is, people do not decide their future, they decide their habits, and their habits decide their future. And that's F.M. Alexander. And that is 100% true. I could not have foreseen where I ended up with my weight, with building half size me, with paying off a huge amount of debt. But it really came down to establishing habits that would redefine my future. I followed Dave Ramsey. I revamped my spending habits, how I managed money. I now stick to an envelope cash-based system. Because of these things I implemented back in 2007, we have paid off $180,000 in consumer debt. We've paid off our house. We're now looking to pay off our new house that we're getting. So it's completely changed my family's tree with money. I instilled 5 big habits into my eating behaviors and health behaviors that caused me to lose 170 pounds and keep it off. And I'm going to share with you those 5 now, because so many people have asked me this. They're like, Heather, I get it. Habits, important. Habits, the things that I should be focusing on. But which ones do you think are the most important? So I'm going to go ahead and give you the 5 that I really feel like have helped me the most. And there's, of course, tons of other little habits, but these are like your 5 big boulders that if you focus on, you will do really, really well. 1, meal planning. Now, here's the interesting thing. I meal plan every week of the year. Vacation, not vacation, holidays, not holidays. Does the meal planning look wildly different based on the fact I might be on vacation or celebrating holidays? Sure. But do I maintain the habit of meal planning 52 weeks out of the year? Every week I plan my meals, even if it says vacation, eating out, eating out, eating out. It doesn't matter, because what it is it's the habit of meal planning. My second big habit that I focus on, I exercise daily. Now, for me, it doesn't matter if the exercise is walking, yoga, strength training, some kind of cardio. It's about honoring the habit of doing exercise daily. It's not dropping the ball on that because I get distracted or I don't feel like it. There's a lot of that I don't feel. I don't feel like it, Heather. I don't try not to fall into that trap. I do the activity anyway. Even if it's a 20-minute power walk. Great. Exercise done. Cha-check. The third thing that I do is I journal my food every day. But Heather, you're not tracking calories right now. That's not true. Yes, it is. Journaling can be paper pencil. I had a half a cup of cottage cheese. I had an orange, right? It can be that. It's photo journaling. It's tracking calories. It's tracking macros. It's tracking points. It's really just being aware of what you're eating. And here's the thing, the method you use, not important. What is important is the personal self-awareness that it draws to your eating behaviors. So if you're somebody who's using a photo journaling app or paper pencil, if all of a sudden you were to go back 2 weeks ago and you noticed you were eating 50% of your plate in vegetables, you were skipping snacks, now all of a sudden you're not eating any vegetables, and you're eating and grazing on snacks all day long, regardless of calories, regardless of points, you can see your behaviors have changed. So when your scale weight starts to creep up on you, you know why. You can fix it. You know what's broken. You know what kind of got disrupted, right? But when we have no clue, when we have no idea what we're doing, whether it's with our money, with our food, of course you're going to struggle, because you can't fix what you don't know is broken. So the awareness that comes from journaling, hugely helpful. The next one, 4, I weigh in consistently. Whether it was a weekly weigh-in when I was going to Weight Watchers, whether it's a daily weigh-in that I put in Happy Scale, I don't allow how I feel about my weight or what I ate the night before to decide whether or not I step on the scale. I step on it anyway. And you guys know I share my weight. I'm open about that. You see, some days it goes up, some days it comes down. That's part of it. But if I am allowing my sensitivity toward the scale to decide when or if I will use that habit. It's not a habit. A habit by its very definition, and I shared this in my post in the community, it's something that you do so frequently, it becomes involuntary. You don't even think about it. So if you were to say, hey, Heather, I have this habit of drinking water, and you established it 2 weeks ago, then more than likely you're still having to give it some real thought. It's not really a well-established habit. If you get into the routine of doing it so much, 6 months, a year goes by, you do it without even thinking about it, right? You know that's a really well-established habit because you're doing it almost involuntary. You're not thinking it through, making a special plan to do it. And this is where I see so many people get tripped up. They do things for a short period of time and they believe it's a habit, when in reality, it's kind of like they're trying something on to see if they like it. And I'll give myself permission to do that. I give myself 30 days to try things. I evaluate what I like, what I don't like. But when we're talking about real progress over time, these five that I'm sharing with you in this video are the ones I've stuck to. They're my tried and true, if you will. And then my last one, support. I have come to the realization after gaining back all the weight I had lost when I was in high school, having tried to do this on my own a myriad of times, that that doesn't work for me. And it doesn't work for the majority of people, whether they're okay with accepting that or not. That's the truth. Those of us who struggle with either substances, alcohol, food, this will be kind of a lifelong struggle, and you're going to need to lean in. I have a lot of maintainers that come back, they'll think they're doing really well, and they maybe are in that moment. And then a life tragedy happens, something occurs, and they come back and they say, hey, Heather, I'm up from where I was. I thought I had this all dialed in. I thought I was okay on my own. And I've kind of accepted that's never gonna be me. So I have support as one of my five things. Because this time, since I've lost the 170 pounds, I maintained it, I've had support the entire time. Whether it was me going to Weight Watchers meetings, whether it was me getting getting help in the Half Size Me community, I have constantly been surrounded myself with support. I've let go of that part of my ego that says I should be able to do it on my own. So that was a huge change. So the five, let's go over them again. Meal planning, no matter what, 52 weeks a year. Journaling my food in some aspect, in some way, it doesn't matter, for self-awareness. Exercising daily, regardless of modality, saving that time every day to do that behavior. Weighing in consistently, not based on how I feel or what the scale is going to say, but doing the action anyway, looking at my average weight over time. And then support, not feeling like I should or need to be doing this on my own. I've accepted the fact that as long as I want to maintain, I need to surround myself with like-minded individuals. I hope this list helps you. And I just want to reiterate this. These are things I have done for the last 14 years at this point. They are consistent and involuntary for me. If they are things you want to instill in yourself, you do not want to drop the ball when you start. Just keep doing it. Keep doing it. Keep doing it. Even when you don't feel like it. Even when you're off the wagon. And that's the hard part. That's where most people do not establish habits, because they make up stories about how they feel about themselves, about the progress they're making, and they never really let these habits get deeply entrenched into their life. They're so busy doing on and off behaviors that they don't get that opportunity to have well-entrenched healthy habits. So try as hard as it is to push aside how you feel about yourself, how you feel about your progress, and say, I'm thinking of my future self right now. What will help him or her in 10 years? If I don't choose my success, but my habits choose my success, then what habits do I need? And what am I going to stick to routinely, no matter what obstacles thrown in my path? I hope this video helps you. You guys have a great day, and I'll talk to you soon.